My son, if you accept my words and store up my commands within you, turning your ear to wisdom and applying your heart to understanding, indeed, if you call out for insight and cry aloud for understanding, and if you look for it as for silver and search for it as for hidden treasures, then you will understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. For the Lord gives wisdom. From his mouth come knowledge and understanding. He holds success in store for the upright. He is a shield to those whose walk is blameless. He guards the course of the just and protects the way of his faithful ones. And then you will understand what is right and just and fair, every good path. For wisdom will enter your heart, and knowledge will be pleasant to your soul. Discretion will protect you, and understanding will guard you. Wisdom will save you from the ways of wicked men, from men whose words are perverse, who have left the straight paths to walk in dark ways, who delight in doing wrong and rejoice in the perverseness of evil, whose paths are crooked and who are devious in their ways. Wisdom will save you also from the adulterous woman, from the wayward woman with her seductive words, who has left the partner of her youth and ignored the covenant she made before God. Surely her house leads toward death, and her paths to the spirits of the dead. None who go to her return or attain the paths of life. None who go to her return or attain the paths of life. Thus you will walk in the ways of the good and keep to the paths of the righteous. For the upright will live in the land, and the blameless will remain in it. But the wicked will be cut off from the land, and the unfaithful will be torn from it. Lord, I just thank you so much for your word. I just ask that you would forgive me of my sins, Lord. I am a fool. Forgive me of my sins, that you would hear my prayers, Lord Jesus, and I thank you for that. I thank you for life, for answered prayer, for my family. I just pray you'd put a hedge of protection around my entire family, Lord, around those watching this video. I just pray you'd bless everyone, Father God. Just be with my family, be with my kids, be with my wife, Lord Jesus. It's in your name I pray. Amen. This verse really jumps out to me. Discretion, this is Proverbs chapter 2, verse 11. Discretion will protect you, and understanding will guard you. Wisdom will save you from the ways of wicked men, from men whose words are perverse. They're not true. Perverse means just, what is perverse? It makes you think of the word perverted, right? Whose words are perverse, who have left the straight paths to walk in dark ways and rejoice in the perverseness of evil. They are not doing this without knowledge of it. They're doing this and they're rejoicing in the perverseness of evil. That is a very scary truth right here. Verse 14, who delight in wrongdoing, who delight in doing wrong and rejoice in the perverseness of evil. Verse 15, whose ways are crooked and who are devious in their ways. I really like how, excuse me, it's just beautiful how this word is so implicable for today. God's word is true and it's alive. It's sharp as a, what does the word say? It's sharper than a two-edged sword, or it's like a two-edged sword, sharpening, poking deep into the innermost parts of your body, into the marrow. Sorry for butchering that. Verse, I don't have it memorized, but it's something like that. Two-edged sword, piercing you down and deep into the most inner parts of your body, into the bone marrows. I do pray that God would do that, that he would do that to me, that I would be alive in him, that his spirit would flow through me, that he would flow through us, that we would be able to bless people, bless our neighbors, and bless each other. I don't really have anything else to say. Just end in prayer. Lord Jesus, I thank you for today. I thank you for the people. I pray that you would bless them, Lord Jesus. Be with our leadership, Lord, in this country. We need good leaders, and I just ask that you would be with them, Father. I pray for our leaders that they would come to know you, Lord, that they would return to your love and your grace, and that they would run from wickedness and perverseness and wicked ideals and ways, Lord, that the perverseness would get destroyed by your love, Lord God. I just thank you in all these things. And it's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. All right, guys. Bye.